Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you. And our friends online, can you hear me okay? Hopefully, yes. Shout if you cannot hear us. And it's a very great pleasure for me to introduce this afternoon's seminar speaker, Professor Hasan Akin. Professor Akin received his MSc and PhD from 100 University in Turkey, and worked for many years at Harlan University and at Summit University in Turkey. He has an impressive list of publications in fields ranging in between statistical mechanics and ergodic theory and dynamical systems. And in particular, one of his interests is cellular automata, and he will give us a brief introduction to the subject today. Thank you very much, Hasan.
First of all, I would like to thank you.
I think maybe you can remove your mask from there, right? So,
well, for your participation in my seminar. Also, I would like to express my sincerity to the Institute of International Education Scholar Rescue Fund and the Science Foundations for their support. In addition, I would like to thank ICTP for support and hosting. This seminar will be an introduction to cellular automata. So I think that most of you are hearing this subject first time, maybe. Therefore, I want to explain the simple concept and the introduction to cellular automata. If the time is not enough, maybe I would like to give an additional seminar in the near future. In this seminar, I will talk about the ergodic properties of the cellular automata, and firstly, I give some definition invertibility, one-dimensional cellular automata. Especially, you know that there are higher dimensional cellular automata, but in this seminar, especially, I focus on the one-dimensional cellular automata. The some ergodic properties, kind of entropy, and other properties. First, I will give some invertibility, one-dimensional cellular automata, then ergodic properties, one-dimensional cellular automata, measure theoretical entropy, topological entropy, directional measure theoretical entropy, and lastly, I will talk about the directional topological entropy of one dimension infinite cellular automata. Okay, cellular automata firstly used in the field of the physics and biology one dimensional cellular automata were first used by Ulam and van Neumann. In mathematical point of view, the Hedlund defined the cellular automata, especially Hedlund defined the sliding block mapping first definition. You know that study of the such the dynamics called cellular automata received remarkable attention in especially in the last few years. Also, cellular automata investigated in a lot of disciplines, for example, physics, chemistry, biology, and neuroscience, a lot of for different purposes. In this section, I will talk about the invertibility of the one-dimensional cell automata, especially in the order ring ZM. Firstly, the Manzini and Margara defined the studied the and given explicit formula of the computation inverse of linear cell automata over ring ZM. Then, of course, if the cell automata is invertible, then related to its global translation map. Also, we check the linear cell automata because in this case we should check it, the global state. Okay, let us consider ZM, the ring ZM. Also, ZM via the sequence of all double infinite sequence. You know that ZM power Z with the Tikhonov topology of direct product. And also ZMZ is a totally disconnected space, compact space. Also, we can study and define the shift map, you know, shift map.
Sorry, what was the end of the definition?
Shift map, we can say that is a shift by sigma. Also, the shift map is a homomorphism of compact matrix space, CMZ. We can define the cell automata. Cell automata is generally generated by the local rule. What local rule? For example, we can consider the any sequence. So we have, especially we use the notation.
Is this an example you're giving now?
No, definition. So we say that the double sequences, and we define the local rule. You know that the shift map is shifting the sequence, and in this case, cell automata, we coding the any finite block. So we obtain the new one. For example, the left, right, okay, F, left, X, left, L. In general, we use the summation.
Can you give us an example? Yes. Is this an example?
Yes. Then Fawad and all have defined the local rule F. They have the state local rule F linear if and only if it can be write as. This one.
Sorry, I just don't understand the first example. Can you give us just a very simple example? You said it's a map commuting.
Yes, I can give a basic and a simple example. For example, let us consider field to Z.
see TF minus 1, 1. Two C three.
For example,
F x minus 1, x 0, x 1 equals 2 x minus 1 plus 1 x 2 x 1.
What do you know?
3. So we can define the cell automata by means of this local rule. In this case, we obtain the new sequences and the iterations. For example, this is sequence double or definite sequence. We obtain the new x, for example, y.
So does this commute with the shift, man?
Yes.
What function exactly commutes with the
not
shift?
For, okay, in this case, we say that t minus 1, 1 sigma df minus 1, 1. Because shift method shifting is all right and the left. And we study the cell automata in this coding.
But what, how is the map T defined?
T defined is yes. 1. Okay.
That's the map F.
F, yeah, okay.
So what's the map T? What's F minus
T, F. F is a local rule. T also.
So how is the map T defined? What is the image of the sequence?
Yes, this is one.
So the first line, first. Second line.
I don't
know. The coordinate I is F applied to X, I minus.
Oh,
F.
I see. For every coordinate, you take you take the two next to it. Uh-huh, okay.
Oh, of course, you can define the higher dimensions.
So at each coordinate, you take a few on each side and you take some average. And then
for example, you can define the higher dimensions. Okay, okay.
Well,
yeah.
Okay.
This map T commutes with the shifts. It's reasonable if the map F, this local rule, is linear in each variable.
In general, but
is that, there are, is that necessary that F is
linear? No. There are a lot of linear, non-linear cell automata, but linear, non-linear cell automata is very difficult problems. And generally, in general, I worked, I studied the linear ones.
But there are examples where the local map is known.
Yeah.
So the linear ones, they always commute automatically?
Of course.
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry.
Yeah. Calculation.
Okay. In this case, I should define the permutive or permutative. Permutivity is very important for the studies. For example, invertibility. For example, ergodic properties and other properties in general. We use the permutive or permutative cell automata. Local rule F is permutative in XY. If for any given sequences, in this case we have ZM, the local rule F, local rule of linear cell automata permutative. This position, if I, if and only if, satisfies this equation. Okay. Okay. Now we can define the way we can study the invertibility of one dimensional cell automata. Firstly, I want to investigate the M equals P over K. Okay. In this case, for example, we can, if we can write the formal power series, sorry, formal power series F, we can write, if we say in this case, we obtain the inverse inverse of the F, and related to we also we can find the related corresponding cell automata. For example, that if F of X is given as question three, then the local rule that associated formal power study and can write it forward in this case. Also, so we needed following theorems on concentrate on the problems inverting the finite power study. This theorem given by Manzini and Margara, let f of x denote the invertible finite form of power series over z fp, h and the f defined as free. Let a g such that this case, then we obtain the inverse of form of power series f. Yes. For example, in this case, for k equal 2, and this problem is very simple. Okay, let us give an example. Assume that the local rule defined as this one, okay, and the related to corresponding power series is one, and we can, of course, we can compute the inverse formal power series.
So, sorry, how did you get the power series from the rule again?
Yes, this is a rule, local rule. This is formal power series.
I can't remember. How did you get one from the other? There's a formula from one to the other?
Yeah, we in general, 9, 3, minus.
Oh.
Exchange it. Minus, plus, minus. Okay. In this case,
but you do that also with when you use I. I mean, this is also any I,
mm-hmm.
right? The formula holds 1, 2, and 3 are just examples, right? Usually, you have I minus one, I and I plus one.
Correct.
And then in the formal power series, you also have I minus one, I and I plus one.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, I'm just trying to understand.
So. We can check this formula modulo 4. Therefore, we conclude that the local rule corresponding f or power minus 1 is 1. So we can compute the inverse. Kolmogorov consistency in this section, I give some properties, ergodic properties, definition of invertibility. Now, I want to give the ergodic properties theorem. Nu is a sigma invariant measure. The following properties are valid. Firstly, secondly, this is a cylindric set. Also, this is cylindric set. This is a say that. The measure nu is a probability measure. Okay, let me see. Also, non-negativity and these properties and these properties say that the Kolmogorov consistency theorem satisfies. In this case, we investigate this theorem. So. This theorem, proof of the theorem 5, can clearly check it for Bernoulli and the Markov measures. Bernoulli measure, you know that Bernoulli measure, in general, we define the probability vector. So Bernoulli measure of the cylindric set C is defined these equations where the pi is probability vector, and you know that the summation of one and non-negative. Another measure is Markov measure. In order to define the Markov measure, we should define the stochastic matrix, and also we should define the probability vector. This satisfies this equation. Okay. In this case, we can compute the Markov measure of any cylindric set such as, okay, in this case pi e 01 elements and stochastic matrix. You know that.
Just to set up one example of this several automata, the ones on Wolfram, right?
Yes, Wolfram, for example. Yeah.
But not all these cellular automata of Wolfram are invertible, right?
Yeah, in general, Wolfram defined the elementary cellular automata.
Yes,
elementary cell. What's the elementary cellular automata? Elementary cellular automata defined on the field Z2.
Exactly, yes.
Z2. A lot of the problems, very important problems, Wolfram, stop on Wolfram, I know, yeah.
So, but not all of them are invertible, right?
No, I don't know. Maybe sometime, in this case, if you study the infinite, maybe you can find the invertibility. But in this case, infinite case, if you take the ZP prime number, of course, there isn't an invertibility. Invertibility, we study the ECO. Generally, in elementary cellular automata case, we study the finite cellular automata.
Yeah.
Finite cellular automata,
so finite means on a finite alphabet.
Yes, no, no.
What is finite?
No, no. For example, in this case, we defined it.
Finite means it's a local row.
Double infinite sequence, okay? Z, C.
Yeah.
For example. But in this case, the finite case, we study the below. Only this one. Okay. In general, the applied, for example, physics, physics, chemistry, and the other science, scientists investigate the.
But what do you mean by we study? You mean that this local rule depends only on a finite number of coordinates? I'm not sure I understand. The definition of cellular automata is always on a doubly infinite shift. Is that right? So what is it that makes it finite? What do you mean by finite?
Finite, for example, in the finite case, you should finite block the finite sequence.
You do what with the finite sequence?
Finite sequence, for example.
Yeah, yeah, but what about the finite sequence?
It's one, two, only we consider this one.
Only we consider?
Finite sequence.
So what do you mean by consider? Sorry, you consider it for what purposes? I mean, what do you mean by you consider?
In general, in this case, we define the matrix, for example, matrix in this case, but in this case, the finite case, that there is not, we not study the matrix, sorry. You know that this theorem is can find the Wolf's books. Let X be means new be a measure space, and let A be a semi algebra that generates B. Let T from X to X be measure preserving transformation. Then you know that. T is ergodic if and only if for A, B, element B satisfy this equation. Secondly, the T is a weak mixing if and only if A, B, element B satisfy this equation. And lastly, T is a strong mixing if and only if for A, B, element B satisfy this equation.
Sorry, what's the difference between the first point and the second? Hence, maybe I'm not to say what.
You know that in this case, you know that the if any transformation is strong mixing, then weak mixing and ergodic, but the inverse generally not the second case.
It seems that they are the same.
The second case, you're taking the absolute value of the difference.
The sum of the absolute
value. It's a little bit, it's just a little bit different.
You know that if T is strong mixing, so
the second is not necessarily
then.
I have not seen the absolute value sign for the second, which makes T ergodic.
But inverse generally not good. Shirvani and the Rogers proved that all onto several automata are invariant and strong mixing with respect to Hermitian. Then Shereshevsky studied some strong ergodic properties of using natural extension of a major theoretical endomorphism. Also, he's answered some question in Rise Sinai, Shirvani. He also defined the anti iteration of the permutative cellular automata. Okay, we can give the lemmas, for example, is very important for us. Okay. Another lemma, Shereshevsky defined. Give it this lemma. We will use the permutative. Suppose that the cell automata defined equation 7 and assume that F is a right and left permutative in this case, and the Markov measure defined on 8. The linear cell automata is uniform Markov measure preserving transformation. Also, this equation is Bernoulli measure preserving transformation. I proved that this case, suppose that at least one of the following conditions satisfied. Then TFR strong mixing with respect to uniform Bernoulli measure. You can study the uniform Bernoulli measure and the another.
Sorry, just to make sure I understand. So the cellular automata is a map
on
the shift space.
Yes. Similar shift, not shift map.
Yes, it was defined as a map, commutes with the shift.
Yes.
But it's a map on the symbolic space, on the space.
For example, coding block map, you can define the block and the block map, the coding by coding.
So it's a map on the same space on which the shift is a map.
Yes, similar to shift map.
It's similar to the shift map, but it's another map on the same metric space.
On the metric space.
On the same metric space.
Yes.
Right. So you're saying that, so you're studying the ergodic properties of this map.
Yes.
So when you talked about invertibility, did you mean actual invertibility as a map on the symbolic space?
Yeah.
That's what you mean by invertibility.
Invertibility.
That the map is invertible on the space.
Yeah, okay.
Is that what similar you mean? Then. It's just my question.
Yeah. For example,
just invertible as a map.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
TF, left right, ZMZ. Similar. Ne olur ne olmaz. Also I give them another theorem. Let Zm be a finite alphabet. And this B is space of double infinite sequences. And if additive or linear cell automata generally given by this question, then we prove that, can prove that F, the TFP strong mixing with respect to Bernoulli measure. Or of course you can study the Markov measure and for example Gibbs measure. There is a also I studied the invertible strong mixing cell automata under some conditions. We have proved that every invertible one.
Sorry, Asim, I just saw that there are some questions. Yeah. Ah. Okay, sorry. They say they cannot see what's on the board. I'm not sure how we can resolve that.
I think they can now after the Zoom chat.
It says, can you zoom in with the speaker lights on the platform?
Yeah, and they did. That was from a little bit ago.
Oh, I see. Okay.
No problem.
Okay, I'm sorry. Yes, I see the room.
Now I can study the measure toward the entropy. Measure toward the entropy concept where has been extensively studied in the variety of the disciplines. For you know that in the physics, chemistry, information theory, coding theory, and so on. Use it for the different poses entropy. In ergodic theory, there are a lot of kind of entropy. For example, to measure theoretic entropy, directional entropy, topological entropy, algebraic entropy, especially in the last years, this is a very popular subject in the ergodic theory, entropy. For example, in the theoretic probability, the entropy is the measure of the uncertainty. Information theory, entropy is null. It's null. Corresponding entropy carries the maximum amount of the information system. In coding theory, entropy infers that the capacity of kernel. Okay. There are a lot of types and the kinds. Entropy. In this case, we in general we define the three steps. First step, the quantity H nu alpha define this one is called the entropy of the partition. Generally, we take the base to the variable. Maybe you can change. In general, information theory, we use the variable. Secondly, let alpha be a partition of the finite entropy, just by finite entropy. Then the question, quantity is called the entropy of T with respect to alpha. So in this case, if we change the alpha partition, then we obtain the different entropy quantity. Also, change the measure, then the entropy is. Lastly, the quantity H nu T is called the measure toward entropy T with respect to nu. In this case, new change the entropy values of entropy change. So you know that if with the help of that partitional sub algebras, it is difficult to calculate the entropic dynamic system from the definition, because we need to calculate for all partition. In this case, in general, we use the Kolmogorov's line theorem. Kolmogorov's line theorem, in order to study the Kolmogorov's line theorem, we should define the strong generator. Okay. So strong generator definition, Kolmogorov's line theorem. You can see the author's books. And alpha be measurable partition of measure theoretical thermodynamic system. The partition is called a strong generator if satisfied this definition. So in this case, we can define, we can compute the measure theoretical entropy by means of the Kolmogorov's theorem. If T is a measure prosonic transformation, but not necessarily invertible, of the measure probability space, and if A is a finite subalgebra B, with can case, we have question.
A and alpha.
So this one?
Yes. There is alpha and then there is A.
Sorry. You are right. This alpha, this we write alpha in seed of alpha. Yeah, okay. Sorry.
So A should be alpha.
Yes. Okay. Sorry. Let me set it. I calculate the measure theoretical entropy additive cell automata generated by permutative local rule with respect to uniform Bernoulli measure. And let us consider the finite field and then corresponding local rule of radius R is permutative in this case. Of course, we can defined in Bernoulli, uniform Bernoulli measure, such as this case, we defined the partition scene. And by means of the partition scene, we obtained the strong generator for one dimension of the automata defined by F. Then let nu p pi be the uniform Bernoulli measure, and for each element at p, then this case, then the entropy of the measure presented system is equals my first result. Is my 20 or 9. For example, let us consider the F local rule, for example, modulo 19. Then we can compute the measure theoretical entropy 5 over 19.
What does modulo 19 mean? Sorry. You've got a shift on 19 elements. Your space is 19
elements. We put in
alphabet.
Yeah.
Okay. I see. Okay.
Another theorem. We obtained another theorem. This is very different. For we generalize the four ZM rings. Yeah. We obtained this equation. That Markov measure find. Also, I give another theorem that nu p
pi p Markov measure given by the stochastic matrix and the probability vector, and assume that L and R are positive integers. This satisfies these conditions, and also F be a one-dimensional cellular automata, then we can compute the entropy, measure torque entropy. Now I can study the topological entropy. In this section, I will investigate the important numerical quantity called the topological entropy of the continuous map, find on the compact metric space, the topological case. Okay. Firstly, Hart showed that topological entropy and not calculated, cannot be calculated algorithmic. Then D'Amico et al. Computed the entropy of two important class, and taking into account approached by D'Amico, we studied the quantity entropy of one-dimensional cellular automata over Zm z. Let us consider this. We say that space-time evolution or space-time diagram, the diagram V and the height T. In this case, denote the number of the distinct rectangles of the with V, W, and height T occurring in the space diagram. Then we can denote the radius of the let local rule F associated with TF, and it is easy to see that this inequality is satisfied. So definition of the topological entropy in case cellular automata, the topological entropy is given this formula. This formula defined by D'Amico et al. Okay. For example, another theorem given by D'Amico et al. That's TF, TV, one dimensional cellular automata, and M denote the prime factor decomposition of M. So we can define the PI set and LERE. So in this case, we can compute the topological entropy by means of a LE and LE. For example, let us consider the local root modulo 36. And we can see that pi 2, pi 3 is 2, 3. And we obtain the L to R, R2, and so on. So we can compute the topological entropy equals. For example. Then I obtained another theorem. And we define this case and the local rule one. If T is invertible, then we can write this equation. You know that in ergodic theory, the topological entropy to T equals topological entropy inverse. Similar. Another theorem and the corollary we can obtain it is, for example, if the obtain this condition, then we can obtain the topological entropy. Okay. Now I can give the directional entropy. Firstly, measure theoretical directional entropy, and lastly, I will give the directional topological entropy. John Milner, you know, John Milner defined the notation of the entropy. Also, Sinai obtained some similar problems, directional entropy, measure theoretical aspect. And the Kaminsky and the Park defined the direction entropy for Z2 action, actions on the Lebesgue space. And then Kaminsky and the Corvage investigate new metric direction entropy, Z actions of the Z2, which is generated by local rule and the shift method. Okay. We can give some define. For example, let see the Z2 action on the X be measure space for a set K subset R2, and the P is a partition. Then we can write this equation. Okay. In this case, we define the topological, directional entropy by means of the block mapping or the cellular automata and shift map, two maps. We have two maps, shift maps and the shift map and the cellular automata. In this case, you can see that directional entropy measure theoretical aspect is equals one, and we can define this notation. And the quantity HF vector, we call the direction mean entropy Z2 with respect to partition in direction V. It is another definition. So, the quantity HVC is one supremum is called the direction entropy of C in the direction V. And, this definition given by Corvage and Kaminsky. Okay, so I just say that TZ the cellular automata, TZ, maybe I can change. In this case, from the definition of the entropy, we obtained this one. Also, another property. Sorry. So we can summarize this result obtained the Corvage and Kaminsky. One, this case, second case, and if the local rule depend by permutative, then the directional entropy measure theoretical aspect is equals zero. It is similar entropy. So I have obtained some results with respect to Bernoulli measure and the Markov measure. In general, in this case, I have studied the upper bounds measure theoretic direction entropy. You know that entropy is positive or negative. So
I can or one can study the upper bones. So my another result, let F be lightly linear local rule, find this one, and we obtain the probability vector, then we have upper bound. Another result, for example, let us give an example. Minus 1, 0, 1, this is a local rule. Then we obtain the formal power series, and we obtain the inverse of the formal power series, and the, related to the finite, local rule is one. Okay, in this case, we obtain the measure theoretical entropy. Another result. Okay, with respect to Markov measure, we obtain another result. So in this case, I consider the Markov measure. Generally, I take the uniform value measure, then we obtain the measure theoretical direction and entropy. Upper bounds. Okay. Lastly, now I can give the definition of directional topological entropy. In this section, I study the quantity of topological directional entropy Z2, actually similar to algorithm Leomico at all. Then I presented an algorithm computing topological direction entropy generated by shift map and Serdot automaton. Let us consider this case in the windows. In the topological entropy, we consider the rectangles. Okay, rectangles. In this case, we consider the parallelograms. Okay. For example, the direction is changed, then entropy is changed. So in this case, the definition of topological or directional topological entropy is given by similar to a topological entropy, but we in this case we consider the numbers of the parallelograms. This definition is by C9. Okay. The formula of directional entropy of B parameter Serdot automata given Miller. Okay. And Bernard and Corbage defined another aspect of the directional entropy. Aspect of the topological. We can define this. We can give the lemma. Corbett has presented the direction entropy by this equation under this formula. In this case, if it is very important in this case, if the angle theta pi over 2. The directional topological entropy takes maximum values and equals to topological entropy. Directional entropy equals to directional entropy. So of course, the exchange. For example, we can see the one example. For example, let us consider the finite local rule. Modulo 5, and then this is, of course, in this case, biparameter because the 5. Okay. We obtain the theta L and so on. So we can draw the sector corresponding to angles theta minus four of the this one, and by using the formula we can compute the entropy related to the local rule. Okay, this one also is a graph, this one, and the direction entropy curves for bi-parameter cell automata generated by local rule given. Okay, my last theorem. Thank you. Let TF be a cell automata or rings CFZ, and then we obtain this set, and similar to the P, and we obtain the entropy. This is very generalized the formula, topological direction entropy. And in this case, I give an example, another example. Let us consider this one, but small. The two case, in this case, two, three, and four, we can obtain. And by means of these values, we can obtain the sectors. Okay, the sectors. Of course, in this sector, the entropy exchange, the sector alone, the sector will change entropy. So we obtain the this formula, compute, and thank you.
Well, you gave us a lot of results and theorems and formulas there.
Sorry.
It's okay. Thank you. Are there any questions?
I have a very basic question, if possible.
Yeah.
So in the definition of the cellular automata, a crucial difference between it and the shift map is that in the definition of the cellular automata, it emphasizes that the alphabet is endowed with ring structure.
Mm-hmm.
So I wonder whether how this comes to definition. Why I missed that point.
Sorry?
Where the definition uses necessarily that you have a ring.
Of, of course, you know that the ring is changed, then the cell automata is changed.
So if I understand correctly, it doesn't use the ring structure. It's just
of course,
using the word because that's
you
what
can a lot of the cell automata. For example, left, right changed, and the ring and the fields changed. You can.
No, so his question is. I think Hamza's question is, do you use, so when you usually consider the shift map on a finite alphabet, you just talk about having a finite alphabet, right? Whereas in your case, you talk about this finite alphabet being a ring. This is your question, right? So do you use the fact that this finite alphabet has a, is it just a finite alphabet or is it actually, do you use in the definition of cellular automata the algebraic structure of the ring?
Of course,
of
generally we use the algebraic aspect. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, well, let's thank the speaker again. Thank you very much.